In experiment 4, you're going to be using a lot of the same techniques that you've already seen, but one new one is called reflux. So we're going to be doing an organic reaction where we're making or breaking covalent bonds. And in that process, sometimes that happens at room temperature, sometimes we need to cool the reaction down to avoid byproducts, or maybe we need to heat it. And so in this experiment, experiment 4, you're going to need to heat your starting materials in order to get to the desired product. And that heating is usually done by a process called refluxing. We're going to choose a solvent with a known boiling point, and then that boiling point is going to be the max heat that's being delivered to our reaction. That way we don't run the risk of burning or scorching any of our materials. If you look on course, you'll see the lecture. There's a slide that shows the refluxing apparatus that we're going to be looking at. So follow along this as we go through the video. Alright, so here's all the pieces that we're going to need for our reflux. The first thing is a round bottom flask. So depending on how much liquid or volume you're going to need in your round bottom flask can determine whether you use the 100 ml round bottom. You can see we only have that thing not quite, maybe a third of the way full. Or if you have less material, you could use this 50 ml round bottom flask. So the general rule you should use is never fill those round bottom flasks to half full. So you always want to be under half full. In this case, I just want to use the 100 ml for whatever instance I'd use that. So along with that, I'll need this heating mantle, so it's a way to provide a flameless heat source. Then I'll also need that power mite that controls the power and the heat to our heating mantle. So we've got a round bottom flask with whatever our reactants are in there, heating mantle, the power mite. We'll need a stir plate and a ring stand with some clamps, and then boiling stones. You should see these somewhere up in the common area. You'll need your West condenser, a stir bar, and then also some silicone grease. So that's all we need to get started with our apparatus. So here's the start of our apparatus. We have the hot plate on the bottom, the heating mantle, and then our round bottom flask. In my case, I used the 100 ml, which fit perfectly into this heating mantle. If you had the 50, then you'd use the smaller heating mantle. So this heating mantle plugs into the power mite, and the power mite has some markers on it. You can tell how much power you're giving to that heat source. And then this actually plugs into the wall. So now you've got this thing plugged up and ready to go. We've got to put on the last few pieces. At this point, before putting on our condenser, we're going to add either boiling stones or a stir bar. So different reactions might require different things. Obviously, if you want to stir it, you're going to add the stir bar. But sometimes just the boiling process in itself can stir the reaction. So in my case, I'm just going to add boiling stones. You can follow the directions in your book. And when you're adding boiling stones, you really only need to add 3 or 4. This just breaks up that bottom surface and helps the boiling process be more controlled. So once you've added that, you want to put the condenser on top. Notice how these two joints are ground glass. So when I put the condenser into the flask, there's that real tight connection with the ground glass. When you heat that up and cool it, sometimes it can actually seize up so that you can't get the two apart. So before actually putting that in for the reflux, you're going to take a little bit of silicone grease, should be in a tube like this, use a wooden applicator, and then you're literally just going to put little tiny bits of that silicone around your ground glass joint. You don't need much at all. If you use too much, then it's going to be globby and possibly get into some of your reaction. So make sure you just use a little bit. Once you've used enough to kind of keep it loose, but not too much, then you'll put that on top of there. and then make sure that this top part is clamped down. So now that we've got it clamped down, we need to hook up the water hoses. Remember the water hose that goes over to the wall comes into the bottom of your condenser and then goes out from the top to the drain. So make sure you've got that set up. Once you've got that, you can turn on the water over at the wall. Remember, you don't need to have the water on too hard, just enough to keep water flowing steadily through that condenser. And then once you've got that going, you can start heating up your power mite. Turn that on and let your reaction heat. So the reflux process doesn't actually start until your solution starts to boil. Once the solvent starts to boil, as you can see it is now, that's the reflux. So if you're supposed to reflux for 30 minutes, this is the start time when it starts to boil like that. So what's happening is in there, the heat that's being delivered to your reaction is being controlled by the boiling point of that solvent. So whatever your solvent is, in this case it's just water or an aqueous solution, that's controlling the heat that's delivered to your reaction. So that reaction is being heated with that kinetic energy, and then as the solvent vaporizes, it's coming up into your condenser, which is water cooled, and then it condenses right back down into your flask so that it can repeat that process. So this process is known as reflux, and it's a great way of controlling the temperature of a reaction based on the boiling point of the solvent you choose. Remember to monitor and make sure that your water is running consistently. If your water is too low, you may run the risk of your solvent evaporating out of the top of your condenser. So make sure to monitor that your water is running properly at a level somewhat like this. So once your reaction is completely done and you've determined that your product has been formed and there's no longer any reason to continue refluxing, at that point you want to make sure that you first off turn off the power mic. So you want this to be off so that the heat stops going to your reaction. The reaction itself, all the glassware, is still going to be hot. So after turning off the power mic, you want to let that sit for at least a few minutes for things to cool down. Make sure not to turn the water off, because vapors are still, even though you turn the heat off, vapors are still coming up, and you want those to condense back down into the reaction flask. So once this whole thing is cooled down, then you can start disassembling things and eventually take your product on the next step. Even though you've used a lot of different heat sources over the years, Bunsen burners and hot plates, this heat source, the heating mantle, and this process of reflux is probably one of the more common organic methods to heat a reaction. So it's a valuable technique. You're going to use it in experiment 4 and then on in future experiments in the first and second semester lab.